Today is still November 4th, 2023. It's still going on. After my work, I was supposed to be in between jobs before the second one got canceled. Or it got canceled and I didn't realize it. I had went through a drive-thru. And you know, some idiot actually said something out a window. You weren't supposed to say anything. That's why they didn't. Okay. We're going to put it this way, sweetie. And I know you're crazy occult people and mindless boobs. Oh, I put it on Facebook of how I got sick, how I got well, what a medication error, false diagnosis, the fentanyl patches. I got a lot more documents. I documented medication error. And how pathetic that family is. I put Jim Jones up there where they killed all those people because he told them to. Because they were mindless boobs too. Okay? They make up reasons to kill people. Now, Will wants to say that he was just acting that way to get the drug dealers, right? He don't want to say that he's a mindless boob. That he was totally full of his mental capabilities while he was talking to me. And he didn't have a stroke or a seizure or a mental lapse. Or he wasn't brainwashed by an occult, right? He was playing them to get the drug cartel, right? That he don't scam rape victims, right? And he does realize in the full capability of his mental capability that he understood what came out of his mouth. And it was a scam. He wasn't just incoherent and having some kind of stroke or seizure or somebody brainwashed him, right? Right? Because you listen to the recorded line and they sold the recorded line. You know, you got to think when that agent was up at that church telling on me the night before, after I called the hotline, I told you they drugged me up for 3 days so I couldn't get out of bed. And then the third day I got enough air in my face to call Sarah where I gave the hotline her information. Of course, Karen, I'll witness for you. I'm scared. Okay, it's getting darker and scarier the way she's talking about. Go on, get her card, put that agent's number, still had me even calling back from the hotline. Okay. And drop it off down the mall. Go up to Apostolic Church of Barberton. Paul Paymer got in Dave's face. My God, I had a FBI agent in my office. He's right there. Okay. I walk off as he's screaming, how dare you bring the FBI up here with threats on her life. Okay, two women walk up. He knows she's being drugged, beaten, raped, and he said he didn't care. I've been covered with bruises, throwing up, lost 18 pounds, and a severe personal infection. My heart sank down in my stomach. Is that what's going on? I walk in. There's a guy with black hair, dark eyes, black glasses, and a cardigan sitting down, and a guy in a super expensive suit. It's gray and it's shiny, long face and growling at people. And I almost thought that was Will. Okay. I hadn't called him back from the hotline. Okay. And I found out later he was a human trafficker. Some of the guys that worked the case have showed up. None of this is funny. We actually seen that guy. Well, he was a human trafficker up there. He stood out in the crowd because his suit was so expensive. It's shiny. I mean, it was very expensive. Okay, I walk in and I sit down. Those ladies follow me. Sit down, he knows she's being drugged, beat, and raped. And he said he didn't care. If she was going to be thinking he was he don't care what they did to her. He's going to turn her back over to him. Can you imagine an agent saying that? No, I cannot imagine a federal police officer saying that because he just became a criminal. You were scamming him, right, Will? You were scamming him to get their drug dealers, right? Because they lied to you that they had sodium pentothal reports, and like the police said, it's not funny they said they had that because you can't even get it. And then on top of it, you want to put it this way, you lie under it. It's spy flick movie stuff, and it's lethal. So they were telling an agent that they were bringing a lethal outlaw drug into the country. is scamming them to get their drug dealers, right? It's not really that dirty, right? Dave comes in, lets go, and he threatens my life and punches me in the truck and tries to punch me till I almost jumped out. And I ran from him when I got home. Next day, I'm scared out of my mind. They all know. And then I'm crying my eyes out. I call that agent. I tell him, I said, they already know. I said, some guy was at that church telling me, you liar. It was verified by the Norton Barberton police. It was the agent that called me back. Okay? We'll put it that way. And I'll tell you what, they pull his records, his phone records, and then office records of signing in and out, who all he talked to. It's that easy. In his own confession, he talked to him on a recorded line. On a recorded line that he met with him. Okay? I told him, he calls me a liar. Okay? Dave told my ex-husband, told our son Danny, when I walked off, he talked to him. Okay? And hundreds of people up there have told other people, because they didn't think it was funny, that a police officer would tell people he didn't care if somebody was being drugged, being raped. Okay? All right. I tell him that some guy threatened to knife me at Giant Eagle. He calls me a liar. There's badgering laws. I went out to eat with an officer. He said, you know, you have to take a victim or a witness statement if you believe him or not and follow through or it's badgering. I said, boy, that's the word I'm looking for. And boy, is that a hot subject. I went on and I looked it up. Department of Justice, 1729. Badgering laws. You have to take a victim, a witness, or an informant statement if you believe them or not and follow through, or it's tampering with witnesses, tampering with evidence, and obstruction of justice. It's like life in federal. So what you did to me was an act, right, Will? Just to get the drug dealers. You didn't have some kind of psychotic break. You didn't have some kind of psychotic stroke. You knew what you were saying to me, right? And it was an act. Right, Will or John? You want to put it that way? I tell him that guy threatened to knife me at Giant Eagle. You liar. Was there a camera above the bench? I don't know. I said he tried to kidnap me before. He's like, you liar. Terry seen him and let me tape her with her permission. He called me a liar. You liar. You say you're a liar? Or arrest you. And I said, what? He said, now was there a camera above that bench when you heard his voice and then he came up behind you? I don't know. He said, you say you're lying or I'll put you in jail. I said, what? He said, now sit, I'll put you in jail. And I'm like, fine, whatever. Listen, the recording line is horrible. The man talks to me like the worst bastard in the world. He's like, now I want you to say you were faking, you were sick. Now, it's a documented medication error. Medical malpractice. I almost died. Had a bunch of surgeries. My muscles locked up. Went to the wrong doctors. Falsely diagnosed me across the board. Gave me the wrong medication. Swelled from my feet to my brain. My heart got off. My thyroid stopped working. My adrenal gland stopped working. And my feet and legs were so swollen, my knees were popping out of place. And I almost died. And it took another doctor to tell me they were only doing it to get kickbacks from the drug company and ripping me off. And then they were wanting to do unnecessary procedures after they made me that sick. And to get an attorney and sue them and get off the medication. And it took me to get with another doctor on high doses of pain medicine and 9 months of pulling myself around after having years of surgery. So, it took me from beginning to end about three and a half, maybe four years. So, and I have scars everywhere. MRI reports showing the swelling, blood work showing everything shut down, and then fentanyl patches that I got on to get out and get moving to my muscles unlocked. Now, do I think it's funny anybody says that was faking? I suffered horribly, and I'll be like where they sold a login. She had to work her ass off to get well. Okay? Now, you say you were... Now, we'll go back to that agent. What are you saying? You say you were faking you were sick. I was really sick before. He's like, you either say you were faking you were sick, or I won't help you. He said, I had those people in my office. That family that lost that kid and heard them cry. Now, what did he just say? Oh my God. What did he just say? He had the Vegas in his office. How they cried and lost their kid and it devastated their lives. You faking you were sick. I was never faking. Strange made that up after he thought I caught his son in adultery and got discarded me and got rid of me real quick. Huh? It's the strangest lie. So you're not like brainwashed, right, Will? You didn't lose your mental capability, had a stroke, or lost your mental sanity for a minute, right? It was an act. You understood you had that family that lost their son in your office, right? You had people in the church and how it devastated their lives and ruined all their lives. Huh? Ruined all their lives because Strange lied on me. You need to realize what you've done. Now, what did he just say? He met with them in his office. So you're going to pull his phone records, the office phone records, and who signed in and out? Be quite interesting, huh? Because he met with them in his own confession. Now, you either say it or I won't help you. I'll leave you there. I said, they're going to kill me. So please don't kill. Let them kill me. They will kill me. You either say it or I'll leave you there. He can't refuse to do his job if you don't do what you're told. I've even talked to the prosecutor's office. He can't talk to you that way. Okay? And please know you can't go along with it. You either say it or I won't help you. Don't let them kill me, please. Then say it or I won't help you. Fine, whatever. Don't let them kill me. Ah. That was an act, wasn't it, Will? Hmm? It was an act, right? You're not really mentally insane and a brainwashed cult person, right? Hmm? Mindless boob. Because police officers and agents are trained that these extreme religious groups are all mindless boobs. They're under somebody else's control. And they will tell them to hurt someone, kill someone. And they'll do it and not think anything of it. Because they've lost their minds. And somebody else is controlling them, what they're saying and doing. They don't have their own free mind and free will. Some other man or woman is controlling them. And they are controlled by these other people to say and do what they're told. They're trained to look at them like that. That they are trained mindless boobs, right? And the whole thing of it is their father ran a stop sign into a semi and killed their kid. I was at home, my whole family was. So somebody's just saying something mean and a lie on me affected them in no way, no how. Wasn't even connected, just went to their church. Somebody just makes a lie up on somebody else, it doesn't affect you. They manipulate people by sucking them in. Oh, that hurt me. That offended me. We gotta kill her now. Do you realize how insane that is? And for an agent to go along with that, of the mental insanity, the morbid mental insanity, because it's just like the Vegas just want to kill people because their son got killed. They just want to go around killing other people. They don't care who it is, right? Because did I have anything to do with that traffic accident? No. Heavens no. I was at home. Brian had to come over and tell us. My whole family was at home. Said they were running late for the church baseball game. There's a bunch of church people behind him. He's a front car and he blew right through the stop sign showing off into a semi. Tell him well. Nobody could believe that he actually didn't try to stop. He's showing off. A stupid act of arrogance cost him and his grandson his life. Okay? That's where I've had even people work the case. That idiot killed that kid. How dare that family open up their mouths to her? That idiot killed that kid. Exactly. And they made up a reason to kill me. It's made up. So that agent was in his full mental capability, right? He wasn't brainwashed. They didn't drug him, right? He didn't have a stroke or a seizure and a lapse of a mental capability, right? It was all an act, right? Because he just understood that he met with that family that lost their kid and had the church people in there too. Of them crying and grieving, how it devastated their lives. It didn't touch their lives at all. It didn't affect them at all. I told the girl that did my hair what they said. She started laughing. She said, "You're kidding." They said, "What? It didn't affect them at all." Exactly. They made it up that it did, honey. It was a scam to control people. It's just like across the street. My neighbor Becky, her husband died last year. My other neighbor's in a wheelchair. If they told her the one in the wheelchair is faking right after her husband died, would she go off and try to kill my other neighbor? No, that's insane. See what I mean? Put it on other people and realize how insane they are. So that was an act from that agent, right? And he did understand in his own full mental capability. He just admitted he had him in his office. Huh? And he met with him, right? And the church people too, right? He understood what he said, right? Right? Then he says, why would the FBI help a person like you? Well, it's a sworn duty. I said, because they're going to try to kill me. So? They've tried to kill me. So? Then the magic words. We could always use Pete's weird blah, 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 blah. And I said, what is he talking about? No, he just said Pete's tapes. He just admitted that the house was bought and I was being Scott. And Dave told Danny, our son, he hired Pete on his own. So who did he just confess he talked to? Dave's hitman. He did understand that, right? And he just admitted they had my house bugged and stalked. Right? And he knew the perpetrator and didn't arrest him, right? He was mentally capable of, stop, she doesn't know, huh? Why? Because this is a washing scene done on purpose, May 26, 22 at noon. In the other room, May 12, 22, they found a tape of them admitting a shower scene in the other room where March was at 1st to 3rd or 21. They were bragging with the neighbors. They put two clips together, put her in a porn. It's not her, it's them. And then later on, what you're describing is showering. She figured out what they did. Ha ha ha. Jackasses. Stocking tapes, moving a washing scene to the other room. Okay. And then they yell out something about Pete's tape or something, and I've never talked to him. I didn't even know who they were talking about. The only Pete I knew was my brother Medina. Never met him. They're yelling out about my rapist that I never met, how he's framing at me and laughing at me like a drunken cat on a bar stool. And I don't know who they're talking about or what they're talking about because I've never talked to him. He's like, stop, she doesn't know. So they just admitted they talked to Dave's hitman that he hired on his own and that I was being stalked. My house was bugged illegally and he didn't arrest him. Huh? So he just answered his own question. Exactly. They all knew. Or I told them they already knew. He just confessed he'd been in contact with all of them. Mocking me about some man named Pete framing me and I didn't know. Okay? Have you ever talked to any law enforcement about the threats on your life? I told him about, I said, well, no. I said, August 8th of 18, there was a light in my security system. I called 911 about midnight and two silly officers showed up. And they told me it looked like an alien orb or an angry spirit. He's like, what? I said, I thought they were dehydrated. I offered them water. I said, but they declined. He started laughing. He said, "Are you serious?" I said, "Then they told me how they handle it in the country to open up the big a door and let a big dog handle it. They didn't want bother." He's like, "You're kidding." They said, "What?" More likely, it was one of those idiots coming over to a drug bee and rape me, and they told me to buy a dog and let a dog handle it. Okay. But I told him, I said, "They just told me to buy a big dog and let a dog handle it." He started giggling. "You're kidding, right?" And I said, "No. Those are the only two officers I've ever spoke to up here. And they were silly. Then I called them stupid, one of the two. Telling me that looked like an alien orb or an angry spirit, and then told me to buy a dog and let a dog handle it next time it happened. Okay? I said, "Those are the only two officers I spoke to up here. Okay?" And then he's like, "Give me a real reason why the FBI would help a person like you." Well, my brother-in-law was a private consultant for the FBI, unrestricted, did war weapons and spyware, and traveled the world and worked under Dick Cheney. That makes him CIA, you know that, right? I told him his name, and when he died, he said, "Well, I can take you somewhere and leave you crumbs with no money." "I don't have money to start. I'll be homeless." "Well, if you agree to get information on Dave and the churches, I can open a format program. Now, if you think you're going against your abusive husband and his psychotic occult people, and they're going to get him real quick, it's not going to be that big a deal. Because he even offered to pull, and you know what I mean? It's not going to be that big a deal. They'll get him real quick. I didn't know I was facing a fentanyl king, the human traffickers, and drug cartel. That's a whole different ball game. That's called hide me fed as fast as you can. You hear me, fed? Hide me. Okay? I was 51 when this started. I'm 56 now. Okay. I said, "Well, I can get information on Dave and the churches. I can do that." "Okay, I'm opening an account with $5,000 a month today." He said, "I'll pull you out if it gets too bad, and I'll make sure no man touches you." Goes through a big whole long list of promises. And he said, "Even when you tell," he said, "we'll always put it back as if it had never happened, and you can't be legally charged for anything again for work in this case, and you have that money to live on when you move out. Okay? And admit to no wrongdoing, and I'll take care of anything and that. But if you try to tell someone, I'll lose you crazy." Now, he was fully competent. The day he talked to me, right? He wasn't drunk. He wasn't on drugs, right? He wasn't high. He wasn't incapacitated, right? He wasn't brainwashed by the cult people. It was an act, right? To get the drug cartel guys because they said they had sodium pentothal reports, right? This whole thing was an act for him. He opened the real case with statements, with money and immunity. Because he confessed he had the Vegas in their office. Church people. He admitted he of Dave's hitman that he was framing me by the stalker that Dave said he hired on his own. I found out later. And that he had been in contact, and he confessed with his own mouth. Right? He was only bullying me so that it would look like he was going along with him and scamming him to get the drug dealers, right? And of course, my case is real. And of course, it stands up in court. And of course, I get my money. They let me get tortured, human trafficked, my skull bashed in. That fentanyl king sold the login. Why do you think the fentanyl king sold the login? Why do you think that human trafficker was up at that church? Because the thought of a police officer going along with an occult and a drug cartel, why would they do that? Attorneys, how?
paying off? Are they scamming them? I was up there to record them. In case he tried to back out. Because of the day that he would denounce my case, they all walk as fraud and entrapment. Because they got it all on police surveillance tapes. Because my case started the next day. Officer showed up. Got back from talking to Dave about the threats on her life. Then Karen around the house, Karen's well, FBI informant started. Everybody already knew, and he acknowledged he had met with him, talked with him. And he knew I was being stalked and framed and laughed how I didn't know by my ex-husband's hitman that he hired on his own. He arrested him. It was an act, right? To get the drug dealers. Of course I could tell anybody I want. You just confess you talked to everybody. There was no keeping quiet. You were seen by the Norton Barberton police at that church. You were taped by the drug cartel, more likely, because that's why the guy was up there telling on me. Because if the case isn't legit, and everybody they got, it would be an entrapment, right? And fraud. Can't enter fraud and entrapment. See, that's what my ex-husband and that retired judge and the drug cartel has is fraud and entrapment. It's not admissible. It's the Fourth Amendment, like my friend from the prosecutor's office. It's a fraud scheme. We can't enter fraud. It's the Fourth Amendment over the house. Police and agencies can only be in a home under a threat of life with statements. There's nothing else. Talk to Officer Reinhardt in Louisville, Portage County Sheriff, Ravenna Police. Even the Massillon Police, nothing they have is admissible before. Nothing. They're not even allowed to look or listen to Fourth Amendment of the Constitution. They can't, Dave can't hire someone to stalk me. He can't hire, people to sell me on porn sites. He can't let people break in and drug me, beat me, and rape me. He's not my pimp. Do you understand? I work for two home health care agencies. This one lady started, I was telling her a little bit what these crazy people did to me. She started giggling. She said, I know somebody who tried that. And then she chuckled. She said, and they're still in jail. I said, well, who's that? She said my ex-son-in-law tried it with my daughter, hired someone to set up buying camera stock in her, photoshops and things, and thought he could get in trouble. Do you know what happened? He got arrested the first day. Illegal monitoring in somebody's home, 7 years. You try photoshopping something and getting somebody in trouble, it's called sextortion. It's 3 to 16. It's a federal crime. It's a federal crime. You let somebody drug, beat, and rape somebody under drugs. It's human trafficking. It's a federal crime. You sell videos of somebody naked without their permission. It's sex trafficking videos. It's a federal crime. You want to talk about where you admitted you put a shower scene in the other room and did it on purpose. Okay. That means you were taping little children going potty. You obtained and dispensed kiddie porn. So that agent wants to say it was a scam to get the drug dealers. Of course he'd uphold the case. Of course Karen would get her money. Of course. That case is real and it's not fraud. And that drug cartel didn't find a loophole. Right? That you were playing the call and the drug cartel, right? That you weren't intoxicated on drugs or alcohol when you talked to me that way. You didn't have a stroke or a seizure or brainwashed, right? It was a scam for you to get the drug dealers, right? Right? Because you did understand what came out of your mouth, right? And it was a scam. See, the whole thing of it is they left me up there to die. They fed me. They were talking about an Olive Garden. They let them drug, beat, and rape her. They even let them human traffic her and torture her and didn't pay her. Well, she's not allowed to say anything. Well, why would I stay quiet? You just admitted you talk to the Vegas and had him in your office. Church people. You made fun of me for the hired hitman that my ex-husband hired on his own, that he was stalking me, and you talked to him. My ex-husband said he talked to you at that church. Barberton Norton police seen you up there. And so did the human traffickers. There was no staying quiet. You already confessed with your own words. You knew the hired hitman that my ex-husband hired on his own to frame me, and you talked to him. You knew my house was being illegally monitored and bugged by a stalker, a serial rapist. A serial rapist. A drug cartel was drugging me up, beating, raping me. Instead, you should, like my friend Sheriff David, he said, is your local police slow? You should have been hit the first day and they all should have went to jail. They can't do any of that. I should have been hit in a safe house. And they should have went to jail. So that agent was scamming them. He was going along with it, right? He did understand he wasn't drunk or intoxicated, right? He didn't have a stroke or a seizure that he didn't realize on a recorded line. He admitted he had the Vegas in the office. He had the church people in his office. He did realize that he stated that he talked to them, right? Because I'll tell you what. People at Trinity Gospel last summer, we all know that one guy in that office had been meeting with all of them. They already been saying that because they sold the login. They also were talking, other women came in an Olive Garden on a Tuesday. I looked it up. He did say he met with those families and others on that line. See, on Walmart Sunday, girls that have been working the case for years and helping out as extras walked in. This is ridiculous. Will did say he met with that family on the recorded line. Absolutely he did. Absolutely. He did understand that, right? He wasn't drunk or intoxicated. It was an act, right? So he could get the drug dealers. Because what are you going to say? You can announce you've already told him the FBI is involved, right? You've already talked to him and cut a deal. And you're just going to scam a victim out of money, right? Well, is that what you're doing? And then the case was fraud, right? You defraud rape victims? Is that it? Well, you defraud human trafficking victims? Well, and you help occults and drug cartels? Or were you scamming everybody to get the drug dealers? Because they were talking, you know, they got really big people off this case. And they didn't pay her. They got really big people, like a fentanyl king, a guy impersonating a prince, scamming almost $1 million, 800 drug cartel guys. See, there were some Latino people in Walmart 62 yesterday were laughing that Will would rather let everybody go than make it right with her. I don't care. That agent wants to let a terrorist go. That agent wants to let a con man of $1 million go. 800 drug traders and serial killers go? I don't care. Gee, who are they going to be mad at when they get out of jail? The guy that tricked them and arrested them. I'm just a pawn. I am a pawn in everything. My ex-husband having that serial rapist Pete, one of his girlfriend's dads, on his own, no court order, illegally stalking me in my home. Illegally breaking in, stabbing me with date rape drugs, lying. They have sodium pentothal reports where I'd wake up with bruises all over me, throwing up, heart racing, almost passing out, a severe personal infection, so bad I can't hardly pee. And I'm going to Altman Family Physicians all summer long. I don't know what's wrong with me. And here I'm being drugged, beat, and raped in my own home. Okay? And it started happening by the second week. I almost passed out in front of the neighbor outside. And come run over to help me. And it kept happening all summer long. I would be throwing up, heart racing, almost passing out. I'd be fine working outside. Come in, wash my hands, make something to eat and drink. Go in and use the bathroom, wash my hands better, take a drink. And I get dizzy. And hours have passed. And it's like, ow, I don't remember hitting my arm out. Man, I must have been tired than I thought. And here, they got roofie confessions. Wake up with marks that look like injection marks. They have feed confessions, and I'd have a swollen, sore, infected personal area and not realize what happened to me, that some sexual predator was breaking in, drug beating, raping me. Dave was human trafficking me out of that house under drugs. He's sick. That's what that agent was mocking. And then photoshopping on washing and roofie confessions. I never met that man they were laughing at me for. That's how sick it is. Some serial rapist preying on women in their home under drugs. That's sick for a cop to laugh at a rape victim by a serial rapist. See what I mean? He and Dave hired the rapist on his own. He confessed. You can't enter stalking tapes. You can't enter fraud and entrapment either. You can put him in jail for trying it, like my client's son-in-law went to jail the first day. See, that's where even police out of this area, what's wrong with your police? They should arrest them the first day. They're not allowed in your house no matter what. Even Officer Reinhardt in Louisville. Even the FBI go to jail being in your home outside to protect a lie case with statements. That agent had agreed to protect you first. No one can look or listen. You don't realize how illegal it is. It's like 7 to 20 years, sweetie. Hiring a hitman to hurt someone or kill him is 10 years. If they get hurt and don't even get hurt, they get hurt, it's 20. Huh? And if they die, it's life. There's actually real laws. And then drugging somebody, beating them, raping them, sex trafficking videos, human trafficking somebody under drugs, huh? There are stalking laws. There's a lot of laws. And then there's constitutional rights that nobody can take away. Fourth, Fifth, Sixth Amendment, and 14th. Had no right in my home. Let alone some serial rapist. Will wasn't drunk or on drugs that day, right? Was an act. Just to get the drug dealers. Because what they're saying is, he can say he talked to the Vegas, he talked to the church people, he talked to Dave. Knew I was being framed and thought it was funny because he's insane, right? He's a brainwashed occult person. And he was ripping off rape victims and human trafficking victims, right? And then the rape victim can't say a word. Because even though he's already admitted he talked to everyone. There was no staying quiet. He was in his full capabilities in his whole mind that he understood what he was saying. That he had the Vegas in his office. Church people. Then he also admitted that some guy named Pete was stalking me and framing me and how I didn't know. And mocking me and laughing like a jackass, like a drunken bar. Like he was some drunk in a bar on a bar stool. Some kind of cad laughing at a rape victim instead of a cop. It was an act, right? Because he did understand he came out of his mouth, right? Dave hired the serial rapist himself. So he admitted he talked to Dave. He was seen by the police telling on me the night before with his own voice. He admitted he talked to Dave. His own voice. His own voice where he mentioned Pete and laughing that how I didn't know with that other guy. He admitted he talked to Dave. He also admitted he had flat out he had the Vegas in his office and church people. He already admitted he talked to everyone. Like my friend from the prosecutor's office, he was only bullying you and the police would know that. He's only a higher police officer. He had no right to even ask you to stay quiet. I said they already knew. He flat out confessed with his own voice. He talked to everyone. There was never staying quiet. He needs to tell him I realized what I said. I realized I told her I talked to him. I realized that I knew she was being framed. And I was just playing all you people so I could get those drug dealers. Of course she'll get her money. Of course that case is legit. We got a lot of bad guys off of it. That would be stupid to let them all go. But you know what? If the FBI wants to let all those bad, bad people go and they all file fraud and entrapment things against them, not my problem. I'm not the one that tricked them. I'm just a pawn that they were coming down here to be hired hitmen and then help themselves and drug traded and serial killed down here. I'm just a pawn. Just like for Ron and Lisa, I was a pawn for their church to kill people. Just like Strange making up that lie, I was a pawn for him to order his people to kill people. I was a pawn.
just like everything. I'm just a pawn that these people are playing to scam money out or have a reason to kill people. It's just everybody using me as a pawn to manipulate, to harm and kill, and trying to kill me and to kill others. It's just a big Ponzi scheme of why they should be able to get away with raping somebody, drugging them, beating them, stealing their money. It's a big Ponzi scheme of people telling people, well, we should be able to do this because of this. You should never be able to do this. My one coworker, her husband went to jail for 20 years. He was a young man. He came home from wherever he was out. He found his sister dying, raped, and literally been cut up and bleeding out. And he, with her dying breath, she told him who did it. And he knew the bastard. He ran out as a young man, hunted the motherfucker down, and beat the fucker to death for killing his sister. He beat him to death. Do you know what happened to him? He went to jail for 20 years. Why? Because he cannot become a killer himself. He cannot become a killer himself. He was to pick up the phone and call 911. He was not to take the... He is not judge and jury. Yes, that man did deserve the electric chair for killing his sister. Yes, he did deserve that. But it was not him to play God, judge, and jury. And he spent 20 years in jail. So why would they be allowed to kill me just because somebody lied on me? They wouldn't. Why would they be allowed to drug me and rape because someone lied on me? They wouldn't. Why were they allowed to hire stalkers to frame me and sell me on porn sites? To human traffic me? They wouldn't. And that agent doesn't have the right to steal my informant money. And the way they're talking, where the guys walk around my apartment that are bragging they stole my money, it's the police officers that watch me. That would explain why they let them drug, beat, rape me and didn't call for help or come help me. There was a sheriff in Ohio took a $100,000 payoff from the drug cartel. He's in jail. They found him. And I was up in Hartville on Friday because my apartment's parked and they sold it. We heard those men that watch her admit to stealing her money. We could hear them outside her apartment. Well, that's not the first time. They were outside bragging they stole my money. And you know what, Will and John, FBI Will and John? Tell you what, they're setting you up to look for embezzlement. I'd like my money, and I need to get to a safe place. Like they said, we realize if she didn't have all these people around her, they would have already came back and killed her. Her mom even seen that guy. He went looking for her. I know that. I know that. I know that. I've almost been shot in the head driving. I had a hide on a shooting night. Faced six stalkers. Got bashed and stabbed in the neck, bashed in the back of the head, raped and left for dead. I was human trafficked and I was raped and tortured, and they sold videos of all that terrorism online. So do you think I think it's funny I didn't get my money and they got thousands of bad guys? They want to let the thousands of bad guys go because they're so busy stealing. That's not my problem. I'm not going to be the one they come looking for. Because it comes down to where the Latino people thought it was funny that the FBI would let bad people go before they would actually do the right thing. That's not my problem. Because when the bad people were out, it's going to be others that pay. And they're going to come looking for the people that locked them up in the first place. I'm just a pawn. I'm just a pawn. That everybody is scamming, manipulating, and trying to make money off of it. And when people realize just how mentally sick this is, maybe they'll start turning them in. Because we're on earth and God's green earth. Just because somebody lies on you? Huh? Somebody lies on you? They can kill you?
No, they can't. Just because some sextortion group breaks in and date rape drugs you up and tells you to say something stupid in your own home, they should be able to kill you or steal from you? No, that's insane. Or Photoshop a washing scene and then laugh at everybody that they fell for, including the FBI, and sell videos of them mocking everybody because you're so fucking stupid in this area. It's like there's retardation in the water. Huh? It's like there's mental retardation in the water. It's a big sextortion scheme. Like my friend from the prosecutor's office is a big fraud scheme. If you don't think the police don't realize it's a fraud scheme, you're not. I'm gonna upload this.